right, the photos that emerged from this month's total solar eclipse were nothing short of breathtaking. I'm out of breath. With us today is Sara Lowthian-Hanna, the lead contract photographer at NASA Glenn Research Center, to share some of her amazing photos. And she keeps saying my team, so it wasn't just Sara. Welcome back to the show.
Thank you for having me.
Okay, were you just as awed as we were?
The most amazing experience. Let's do it again.
Seriously, yeah. This was your first one?
First total, yeah.
First total. So the other one I hear is coming in 2044, so we can stick around and travel,
yeah,
I guess.
I'll jump on a plane somewhere, hopefully.
I know. All right, so let's talk about this. What was your experience like? I mean, I know pretty much everybody was the same. We were like, oh my gosh, but were you expecting to see certain things that stood out to you?
Yeah, I was looking forward to some of the photographs that we could capture, yeah, of the different phases of the eclipse.
And did you use, I know the last time you were on our show, you had all these cameras. So what did you guys use? Like, where were you all set up?
We had cameras set up all over. So we had some cameras set up at NASA Glenn's Research Center, and we were also set up downtown at the Great Lakes Science Center.
Oh, cool.
So our team was spread out, and we got a range of different photos taken.
And where were you sitting at the time?
I was at the Science Center,
you
and
were.
I got to watch totality with the NASA administrator.
Oh my gosh!
With astronaut Snoopy, because, you know, that's pretty cool.
And yes, there's a lot of astronauts.
The mayor was next to me and other elected leaders. So it was
It is a once in a lifetime experience. Now let's show some of your pictures, because we have some still shots that we're going to show you. These look way better than what my camera did, my phone camera. So explain what we're seeing.
Yeah. So this would be the totality. So
now we talked about sunspots, corona, prominence, diamond ring.
Sure.
Did any of that show up on your pictures, or can you kind of touch base, like, or kind of go into detail about that?
Absolutely. So this particular one we see is of totality, and we normally can't see that because the sun is just so bright. So
right.
When the moon blocks out some of that light, we can see the corona around the sun.
Okay, so that would be the corona picture.
Yeah.
Okay, what about the... Now, I saw that, and my neighbors and I, we were in her backyard, Megan, and we're like, what is that?
So this would be the beginning of what's called the diamond ring.
The diamond ring.
Do I have one? I have another version right here too.
Okay.
So there's, you can see it at the beginning of the eclipse and at the end of the eclipse. So,
oh my gosh, that's
what's
so
happening
pretty.
Is the moon is passing through over the sun, and you see this really bright area in the valleys of the moon, and you can see just the beginning of the corona. So,
oh,
and that looks like a ring, right?
Yeah, it
looks
does
upside
look like
down
a ring
here.
Okay. All right, and then the sunspots, did you talk about, now what is this angle from? Where was this set up?
This is downtown at the Science Center. So, the atmosphere was just so cool. The city lights came on, you looked to the other side of the lake, and you could
right.
see what resembles a sunset. It was just a really cool atmosphere.
Now, so what went into choosing where you were set up, all your cameras? Because you were looking for the right angle, right?
Yeah,
okay.
And we had an app where we pre-planned everything, where the moon would be and where our cameras would be.
Sure.
So all that, we planned all that out.
Okay, and what was the prominence? I'm looking at my cheat sheet because I know nothing about this.
Yeah,
you think I would have learned on our live show. The prominence, what is that?
Everyone has questions about this. The prominence. We saw during totality these little red loops around the outside of the sun.
Okay. There you go. Can you guys see that?
Yeah. Okay. There's these little red loops, and those prominence are made of materials. It's made of plasma. And it creates a loop around the magnetic field around the sun.
Wow.
So, yeah, that was really cool to see just with your bare eyes.
Yeah.
You can see those little red outer edges.
Right, and I did take my glasses off when it was okay,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I can still see you.
You can, yeah.
I took some pictures of my own. So here's what I did. So once it went to totality, I kind of took the filter off my cell phone, and that was okay.
Yeah, yeah.
So I think we have some of my pictures. This is definitely not mine. Hold on, they're coming. Wait for it. So we were at my neighbor's house, so I woke up from my nap early. I had to set my alarm because I wasn't going to miss it. And so we went over to my neighbor's house, and it was like, it was the before. So this is my neighbor, Megan. She's awesome, and she was just pumped the whole time. Like, the whole cul-de-sac came over to Megan's house. And so, anyway, it was that leading up to, you know, that excitement, you know, and she was so excited. We all were. These are my kids. This is Duke and Kendall. Capri slept right through it. She's three. So she was at her nap, and this is my husband and I kind of joking around. I said, Hal, take a selfie with me. But this was fun. And then my pictures, I mean, they were just not as good as yours, obviously. Well, you were using that telescope that you brought on our show last time.
Yeah, we had a whole different range of lenses that we were using.
Yeah, and so all these other pictures were just from that day. So
yeah,
that's really cool. I love all these too.
Yeah.
You guys need like postcards or something to like sell at the Science Center. Are you gonna make something out of all this?
That's a good idea. We should do something, huh?
You're welcome. Okay. Sara, thank you for coming in.
Thank you.
I'm glad you had
me.
Just as much fun as we did.
Yes.
It was awesome. You can see all this at the Great Lakes Science Center as well. So for more information, you can go to our website, fox8.com. All right.